We're back.
They're back.
It's Wiz and Dtyson.
It's Batman
versus Superman. Hi, welcome back. I'm Superman Wiz, and he's
Batman Dtyson.
Yes, and so finally we get around to talking about this movie, because the movie we just saw, if you didn't already catch it, is Batman versus Superman.
Yes.
So yeah, we finally get to talk about it, even though it's been a couple of weeks since we've seen it. But I did write down notes on my little pad here, so we're going to keep this non-spoilerish if you haven't already seen it.
All right.
Yeah. So are you going to ask me, do I bleed?
Do you bleed?
No.
You will.
Hopefully we don't bleed during this movie log. Anyway, so there's a little bit of, like, steps we're going to go through this on this special occasion of movie log is we're going to talk about the trailers.
Yeah, let's do it.
It's Wiz and Dtyson.
Okay, so the one of the few trailers I remember is the new Ghostbusters movie. What did you think about that?
Well, it could be a good take. I mean, it's got a female version of the Ghostbusters. It seemed kind of funny at times. It could work. What do you think?
I don't mind the all-female cast deal with it, although it kind of feels weird, because it was like, in the trailer, it was like 30 years after the original Ghostbusters or some shit like that. They're like, this paranormal activity is all happening around New York and whatever. It's like, they make it sound like it's the first time, and I'm like, something feels wrong. There's something wrong. Like, there's a good idea behind this, or like a concept going on, but
they're just too oblivious.
Just something needs to be worked out. And then someone kind of brought up a good point about the ghost in the movie. Aren't they a little too colorful? Because in the original Ghostbusters, they kind of look terrifying-ish. Cartoony, but still kind of terrifying-ish.
It's true. I mean, Slimer is part of it, right?
Yeah, he was kind of the exception. He was the one that actually kept a very disgusting look that, you know, you don't like him for his visual appearance, but, you know, you kind of like him as not a character, but like kind of like a piece of the character.
That's true.
So then... Then there's the next one. Hardcore Henry, the first-person movie film, which kind of looks like a first-person video game like you mentioned.
It does. I imagine a lot of people would have motion sickness watching this film, but...
Do you think it would be... Because at the time we're talking about this, it's already out. So do you think it would be worse in 3D if you watched it in 3D? Because I imagine it'd probably be more sickening.
In your face. Yeah, definitely.
But I thought the concept was kind of, not original, but interesting, just completely, purely first person, because then you are literally the character. And if they keep that up, then that'll be good, because if they suddenly break to, like, a third person camera or, like, view, and it'd be like, you ruined the movie. Sorry, no, I see right through you with X-ray vision. There was this one that I forget. It was some Harry Potter-inspired movie written by J.K. Rowling. Yeah. There's not much to go on about that. It was just like, they're in London and magical shit is happening. There's like some breach in the Ministry of Magic, and there's just like... I don't know. Did you ever watch the Harry Potter movies?
I've seen, I believe, the third and the last one and maybe the second. Yeah.
The first and the second one were like the best ones. I wouldn't say it went downhill, but it did kind of change as it goes on, and I don't want to say they're bad, because I've seen 1, 2, 3, and 4, but I never saw everything past that. And well, I guess they're not bad, but I like the first two. It was very magical.
Well, speaking of bad, Batman versus Superman was getting a lot of bad rap from critics.
Moving on.
It's Wiz and Dtyson.
Well, before we get into bad raps about Batman and the Bat Blood,
yeah.
Did you like the film, Batman?
You know what? Going in was blind as a bat. I thought it was done well. Script-wise, maybe there were some loopholes, but...
Inconsistencies. But overall?
Overall, I think it was done well. I give it a good movie. I'd say it was a good movie. What do you think?
Well, being that...
Was it a super movie, Superman?
Well, it definitely had a Superman's... I almost said Super Batman. Superman, Batman. It was definitely... I definitely enjoyed it. I liked it. I went into this movie not knowing anything about it.
Yeah.
I didn't really watch the trailers at all, because, you know, trailers are always a P piece of shit.
Yeah, you should let them.
Oh wait, I shouldn't say that because I'm Superman.
Let them trail behind. Go into a movie blind as a bat, and you'll enjoy it.
I will bring up this. Remind me to bring up the thing about the trailers later again for like the Batman Superman because it actually did something where like I'm glad I didn't watch the trailers, yeah, or else it would have like just been like this movie would have been no surprise to me. But yeah, I liked the movie. I enjoyed it. I didn't take it that seriously, and it was quite enjoyable. So.
I think what
I'd say I'd like it.
I think what the critics, their expectations were too high, and they were expecting the film adaptation to be accurate to the comic books. And when has a comic book film ever been 100% accurate to a comic book? Never, okay? So get over it.
Wasn't Watchmen mostly accurate?
No, they changed a lot of stuff, too.
It was
missing a lot of stuff, yeah.
So
when people go in to see these movies, they should go in for the entertainment value. Don't expect the comic to come to life because that's really hard to do. Because with a comic, I mean, you can put a lot of your own spin on it when you're reading
as much as you want.
Yes.
Everyone has their own views. And then there's just some things that just don't work.
Yep. But what can we point out from the...
I noticed, Batman, that you were analyzing the movie and kind of noticed that the superhero war movie is like coming about, especially with Captain America: Civil War.
Civil War, yeah.
So what did you want to talk about with
that? Well, I just feel that they're happening at the same time. I don't think it's a coincidence that DC and Marvel are both putting out these kind of films where like we got heroes against each other and then they have to kind of team up and Justice League and all these.
Do you feel that DC got kind of scared that Marvel is going to win because usually they do a very good job?
I believe so.
So they had to like, we have to get this Batman versus Superman so that we can get a lot of hype and view for it. So
definitely. This definitely seems like a product placement for the Justice League. It was very, you know, all put together.
Rushed
as well. Yeah.
Yes, as we'll go on to later about the parts that I didn't feel quite rushed, but at the same time, you can't say it wasn't rushed.
It's Wiz and Dtyson.
So, the actors. So, I have never seen Man of Steel, and apparently about half of you watching don't like Man of Steel, because you don't like Man of Steel. So, what did you think about the actors? I know you were doing your research on Man of Steel.
Yes, I did my homework.
Okay, so, first one is Superman.
Superman, played by Henry Cavill.
I thought he did a pretty good job being me.
Yes, he did. He didn't do a super job, but he's a pretty believable Superman. He looks the part. As Clark Kent, maybe, I don't know, I think I prefer Christopher Reeve's Clark Kent compared to Henry Cavill's, but as Superman, he definitely embodies that character, I believe. Just his presence alone. He has that look about him, Superman, yeah.
Well, so this is my first time seeing Superman in this reincarnation of him, and I gotta say I really liked it. I was actually surprised that his Superman in this when he was in a Superman because I always remember the Superman the animated series where like he's really buff and stuff, but Henry Cavill, I gotta say, you look pretty good in the Superman suit. Yeah. Like I was like it looks very, very believable.
It suits him well for sure.
Yeah, unlike perhaps some of the older ones where it just kind of looked cartoony and somewhat bloated. This Superman, he looks strong. Like he looks like he can kick some ass if he wanted to. As Clark Kent, didn't see too much of him in this movie. Like there were parts of him, and he looked all right. He definitely looked different. Like he looked kind of like a wimp, and getting freaky with Lois Lane.
He still looked like a big dude though.
He looks kind of like reserved.
Reserved.
I think that would be the word I'd say. He looks reserved as Clark Kent, which is good because you don't want to look like Superman.
No.
Although he had the same haircut or hairstyle throughout the thing, so nobody was. Kryptonite.
We'll be back.
Hang on, superhero time.
When you're super hearing, you were able to hear somebody who needed your help.
Yes, I heard someone in distress. Someone trying to get through the front door. But we'll leave it at that.
Yeah. So enough about.
So, anyways,
Cavill, what about Ben Affleck as Batman?
Actually, no. We were going to talk about Lois Lane when you brought it up.
Oh, Lois Lane. Okay.
So what did you think she did in the movie? I think she did excellent because. No, but.
Well, you know what, Amy Adams, I felt like in the scenes where she was really supposed to convey
Her love for?
Her love for Clark and Superman. I felt like her acting was a bit, I don't know, I wouldn't say lackluster,
not believable?
A little bit, right? Did you feel that way too?
Or wait, maybe the word force would be kind of...
No, not force. It's just not there.
It just isn't natural, yeah. Like, she was trying too hard, maybe. Yeah.
But how dare you talk about my Lois Lane? But, yeah, she's just kind of...
A little bit, right?
She's the damsel in distress, and that's what Lois Lane is about, but...
She gets captured quite frequently in this film.
Gets captured once, yeah. Twice... I could have sworn there's probably a third time somewhere. I thought she did okay.
She did okay, but not great.
But not like, you know, outstanding. She was there to be something for Clark Kent to believe in, to consult into, because she's the only one that knows he's Superman aside from his parents. So
yeah, it's true.
She is the source of his motivation.
Yeah, I guess
we'll
see
that. Wow, that was short. Now, who do you think we're gonna talk about next?
Well, I think Ben Affleck. No.
No, we're gonna talk about Wonder Woman.
Saving the bad for last. All right.
Or maybe I think he just should be in last place. So right. Wonder Woman.
All right. So this is.
I would say there's not too much to talk about Wonder Woman.
Yeah, she's played by apparently a former or model, I should say. I think she's still a model, Gal Gadot.
Oh, really? Because she looked. As a model, she looked pretty good as Wonder Woman, I gotta say. Yeah. Apparently, a lot of people gave her some flack, like, oh, she doesn't look like Wonder Woman, and maybe the civilian, in her civilian disguise. Okay, she did a good job tricking me, despite my X-ray
vision. The thing
vision.
Is, those who know the character Wonder Woman, she was never like this, you know, great...
Bulking Amazon?
Bulky or muscular character, so...
No, she's like supposed to be the slender,
yeah,
but
so
muscular.
I think it made sense having her casted as...
It worked out. She was very intelligent in this movie. I always thought the Wonder Woman I saw was somewhat a little naive about, like, the world of man, but she was like... You know, she believed very hard in what the Amazons believed, what they should do to help mankind. This one's a little different. She's kind of like a secret agent, because I noticed, even though I was not in that scene, I saw her took something from you, Batman.
Yeah, she took
How'd you feel
some,
about that?
She took some information that I needed at the time.
But she gave it back.
She gave it back in her way, yeah.
For some reason.
And then she gave me information of other characters.
Yes, which we will discuss later. Okay, so what did you think of her... what did you think of Wonder Woman as Wonder Woman? I thought she looked good.
Yep. I wouldn't say she was wonderful, but she did her part well. And
it was done pretty well.
Her theme was pretty epic.
Yes.
Right?
I have that theme down.
The music, yes. You knew it was her. It was like this kind of tribal... Meshed in with some maybe Xena warrior in there, right?
Yeah, definitely. I would go with that.
Are we gonna get to the freak? Are we gonna get to him, Jesse Eisenberg?
Not
Lex Luthor, not yet.
Okay. First, we're gonna have to talk about your butler, Alfred.
Oh yes, yeah.
One thing, I thought he was Robert Downey Jr.
Yeah,
but he's not.
I guess it kind of helps that the actor's name is Jeremy Irons, kind of like Iron Man. He did seem like a Robert Downey Jr. He was too cool to be Alfred, I think, in a way.
Yeah, but, he's kind of too techy and too kind of snarky.
Yeah.
Like, he's different. He's not quite the caring, loving butler that
you usually have.
He's kind of like the snarky, like...
He was snarky.
Like a best friend, sort of,
yeah.
Which kind of worked in a different kind of way.
Yeah, he was definitely not like the servant type, right?
Not completely.
Yeah.
But, like, you know, all Alfred...
Like, Mr. Wayne, I will get you your Coke and pizza. Right, he wasn't doing that at all. Right, he didn't really do that in this film, but he did a good job. I mean,
their take on Alfred was acceptable.
It was different. It was cool in its own way. Yeah,
and I think that's kind of what I appreciated was like, because we always saw the nice, kind old man, butler.
Alfred. Yeah.
So it was nice to see a little bit of a change in that, because you know we've seen that enough. If you want to see like the kind-hearted like Alfred, just watch the older Batman movies.
Yeah.
I mean, if they're going to make a whole entire new... If Zack Snyder is going to make a whole entire new take on the DC universe, might as well go all the way, because you can't say he's half-assing it.
Yeah, definitely.
So, Ben Affleck as Batman, the one everyone raged about.
Well, you know what? It's funny. Back in 1989, when the film... Well, the second Batman film came out, technically, because there was a 1966 film. But when that film came out... Michael Keaton also got a lot of flack for playing the role of Batman before they people saw it, obviously. And after they saw it, they appreciated it. And I think similar things rings true about Ben Affleck's portrayal of the Batman. Critics actually didn't... they weren't displeased with it. They liked it. They said the film itself wasn't that great, but they liked
Online critics were like, a Ben Affleck as Batman.
Beforehand, yeah. But then they appreciated it after, right? After
the I don't know. Maybe they still didn't like him. But okay, but from my perspective, I thought he was a pretty fine Bruce Wayne. As Batman, he was kind of chubby, like Frank Miller's. Yeah. Well, not chubby, but, you know, husky bulk.
They were definitely aiming at that, yeah, to have like that Frank Miller portrayal.
Yeah, Dark Knight. This Batman Dark Knight was a little fat. I think he was still it was like more fat in the muscle, so yeah. he was slightly bulky, especially if you're gonna have to take your chances against me.
That's true. But yeah, this Batman is definitely no holds barred. He's definitely a darker Batman. He's not afraid to shoot if he has to.
Not emo, but like more depressed or like very more negative.
Yeah, he's definitely drinking a lot in this film too at times. Yeah.
Yes, and always aiming for me.
Yeah, Superman. Well, I mean, there's somebody who's plotting to have us battle each other out, right? And
funny you mentioned that, but the next one who gets much more flack than Ben Affleck is Jesse Eisenberg as Lex Luthor.
Yeah.
What did you think about that, Batman?
Well, Superman, I believe that he was coming across more as a lunatic character.
I would say wackier.
Yeah, wacky character, a la, you know, Jim Carrey's portrayal of the Riddler, a.k.a. Edward Nygma from Batman Forever, meshed in with some Heath Ledger Joker. That's what it came across to me.
He came across very silly, like just previous Lex Luthor, that you had this like very, this presence that made him look very, not professional, but very, about his... But you feel his presence, his strength when he comes up. But this one is kind of jokey.
He's a little all over the place, yeah.
And he looks... And it looks like a Lex Luthor teenager.
Yep, definitely.
You may take that as a compliment as me saying you look young. Maybe a little too young for it. And the wacky hair, the wackiness is just... It felt very weird.
No, I'm not criticizing his acting. I do believe he's a phenomenal actor, but for this particular character, it did not feel like a Lex Luthor at all. That's what's missing here.
Yes. Although he did sort of begin looking like Lex Luthor at the end, but he still was kind of like...
Oh, just because he shaved his head.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, looks can be deceiving. He didn't feel like Lex Luthor, to be honest. I mean, I don't know why they went to that angle. I mean, maybe they miss having a
Joker. He also kind of feels like a little spoiled brat.
Yeah.
Which Lex sort of kind of is, but not to that extent. Like, I'd expected more professionalism in his character.
It's true.
So, if anything, if you thought Ben Affleck was kind of weird, I'd say Jesse Eisenberg was a little weirder.
I think that's why the critics were so harsh on this film, because of...
Even when they were, it was announced. Even when it was announced, it was already like...
Oh, they didn't like having him as a...
They thought it was weird, and I think their belief was kind of right.
Yeah. It's true. All right, well, what else are we going to tackle here, Superman?
The Experience. It's Wiz and Dtyson. Well, so what did you think of the action in this movie? Because I think the action's great, because I was kicking ass.
Yes, we were both kicking ass. I think that the effects were pretty well done. This was a very big budget film, actually. They spent apparently $250 million on this film.
Oh, something that Bruce Wayne could pay.
Yes.
Is this funded by Wayne Corps?
Wayne Enterprises, yeah.
Yes.
But... yeah, the action was in your face. It was fast. It was hard. Explosive action for sure. A lot of shooting. That kind of surprised some fans, I believe. But hey, Batman's a dark character, folks. He's been dark since he.
And you've used the gun before.
He has used a gun before. Or I have used a gun before. Yes, the zapper. But more.
But yeah, the action was good. If anything, if you come and watch this movie, you can at least enjoy the action, especially the fight between me and Batman, and also against Doomsday at the end.
Yeah, Doomsday. Although that felt more like a Godzilla flick, didn't it?
Actually, at one point it felt like a Dragon Ball Z fight, which we'll get into later.
But, yeah, So for the action aside, if you believe that 3D will enhance the action, it does not.
Not yet.
Sorry, my bad.
So next is the music, and I remember the music being like quite good.
You know what? I don't really remember the music as much as obviously Danny Elfman's epic Batman score, but.
But it was kind of there.
Their Wonder Woman theme is what I still remember from it, to be
honest. That's the one I remember
most. That's about it.
I know the other themes exist, but the Wonder Woman theme is the one that sticks out the most.
But I think.
Because it did have the Batman theme, sort of, in there.
I think even the Dark Knight series also suffered from. Like, the music was okay, but you didn't like really remember it after the fact, right?
Or you wouldn't listen to it outside of the action sequence, which it's very true.
So I think Danny Elfman's the only composer who actually made you just want to listen to it by itself. It was that good. Just that masterpiece. Yeah.
Yes, indeed. But otherwise, music fits the mood. Fits the mood of the movie, and of course the special the themes of the characters too. So now we get to go into the 3D.
Oh, you got your glasses on.
It's Wiz and Dtyson.
I did not like the 3D. In the beginning, it really hurt my eye when they were doing the effects with when the bats coming at me.
Yeah, that's
I think
true.
I can now see your fear with the bats.
Yeah,
but that would three. The 3D was not worth the
price of admission.
Yes,
yeah, I definitely agree.
What did you think of the 3D?
Yeah, it just didn't really work. A lot of the films these days don't really, I don't know, they don't really make full use of the 3D effects.
Like it might have looked like during the Doomsday fight, like maybe, but even then, it didn't need to be in 3D. And that's the thing. This movie didn't even need to be in 3D.
It did not.
It was unnecessary. Yeah, I think that's the word. Just unnecessary.
Yeah, so if you can,
avoid
3D.
Yeah. Only reason you'd watch it in 3D, like in our situation, is because for some reason they want to push that so there's more times for a 3D movie.
Yep, that's the only reason why.
Because otherwise we would have watched it in 2D, and it would have been just fine.
So 3D, no chance. All right. Who needs 3D when you got laser vision? That's true.
Superman should shoot red and blue lasers.
It's Wiz and Dtyson.
Okay, the general plot. So what's the general plot of the movie?
Well, general plot is heroes are a...
Well, maybe I can help you.
Not a dying brand, but there's something that it's not fully understandable. Like what makes a hero? The crowd... Not really the crowd. The public is not sure whether to trust Superman or to trust
basically,
Batman.
Basically, people questioning whether I'm a threat or not to people.
Yeah, and they do the same with me, with my brand of branding criminals.
Although, compared to me, I'm a much, much bigger threat.
Supposedly, but...
Yes. And then the other thing is Lex Luthor trying to make me look bad, like the bad guy.
It's true, so that we could... battle each other.
Yes, for a great detective like you, you sure believed him.
I did. I did not use my judgment well. I did not take your part of your humanity. I just saw you as an alien, as a threat, and that's why I went after you the way I did.
Yes, you tried to kill me for our awesome showdown.
Yes, we did. But we did put up a hell of a fight, didn't we?
Yes, and after a series of events, we then head on to join forces with Wonder Woman to fight Doomsday.
Gee, I wonder why.
Whoa, man.
Yeah.
That's some puns there.
They were trying to push the whole Justice League, so this is where the whole film, you know, delves into.
Yes, the start of the Justice League, hence called Dawn of Justice.
Dawn of Justice.
And that was essentially the plot, so.
Can't really touch on more on that, can we? Rather than. We don't
spoilers!
Are we going to do spoilers?
It's Wiz and Dtyson.
That's why it's in the second part of this.
Okay, right. So this is spoilers, guys, for a spoiled brat like Lex Luthor. Although he wasn't really a spoiled brat because apparently his father was abusive.
Okay, into spoilers. Yeah. So I'm going to be reading this a lot because I don't remember the movie too much, but I try to remember everything from when I was writing down. Deeper into the plot, people questioning Superman as a threat or not from the incident in Man of Steel where he caused several tons of buildings to collapse, which is shown in the beginning of the movie as kind of a recap from your perspective, Bruce.
That's true.
I mean, Batman.
That is true. I helped one of my well, I wouldn't say co-workers, but I guess it is
one of your employees.
Employees, sorry, that's true. Yeah, helping one of the employees that after the building collapsed, his legs had gotten
amputated.
Trapped.
Oh, actually, no. It was amputated later.
Later on, yeah.
Yeah, so then you start to question this, do the same thing as the people and question it from the same incident, being that you were in that incident for some reason. We didn't see this in Man of Steel.
No, did not.
And then Lex Luthor is planning to get rid of me because he doesn't want humanity to be controlled by a godlike being or people like me, like Zod. Yeah. Who makes an appearance in this movie as a corpse.
Yep, General Zod. A very general appearance at that.
A very generic appearance?
Yes.
Oh, I think I remember now. The people that were supporting me got killed, and then I get blamed for killing them. That was the deal with what Lex Luthor is trying to do. Because he's trying to use kryptonite against me.
Yeah, he also tried to make you look like you're the one who killed those terrorists. But it was, it was actually one of their own who... Or, like, Lex...
Yes, yes.
The underworld type guys, yeah.
The private... The PMCs.
Yeah, they framed you.
But Lex Luthor couldn't obtain the kryptonite legally from... what was that one place on the other side of the planet that they had to get it from? It was like...
It's not planet Krypton?
No. In Man of Steel, the two machines that were drilling into the Earth, there was one in the city of Metropolis and then one on the other side. The other side had the kryptonite, and they wanted... And Lex Luthor couldn't get it, so he had to do it illegally by blowing up the conference I was in with his Secretary Mercy, who looks hot, by the way. Yeah, I was surprised. She dies in this movie, like, immediately.
Yeah, Lex shows no mercy, and Mercy blows up. That's pretty dark. But,
Mercy's a no-show now.
Yeah. No mercy.
And in the meantime, you're trying to do your criminal justice and finding this Russian guy.
Yeah.
That's another one of the
things.
I'm
also looking for the white Portuguese, but we find out that it's actually not a person.
Yes, you steal the encryption keys from LexCorps, because apparently he has information on it. And then you stumble across some interesting data about metahumans to start up the Justice League.
So you got the Wonder Woman.
Flash.
You got the Flash.
Cyborg and Aquaman.
Aquaman, yep. And
which is part just to set up the sequel to this, most likely.
It is.
And do you doubt this?
Doubt what?
Do you doubt that?
No, it's definitely going to be a sequel. But this is where the film doesn't really make sense. I don't know how you feel about this.
We'll get into the inconsistencies later.
Okay.
So you also wanted to use a kryptonite against me, so you steal it from LexCorps, leaving your symbol there, of course, so Lex knows it's Batman who stole it for some reason. Can you explain why that happened?
I guess I was trying to show that I'd been there and that I was going to take out Superman by any means necessary.
Yes, because
knowing that kryptonite is his weakness.
Because the other thing is all of Superman's loved ones are put in danger by Lex Luthor, so I have to kill you in order to make sure they're safe.
Actually, which brings an interesting point. Did you feel that moment where Lex is trying to use you? Did that feel like a Dark Knight flashback? Where
is she?
The red eye. Well, in this case, he has red eyes.
It seems like that
kind
of thing.
It seems like a Dark Knight moment. But you were the one saying, where is she?
Of course, we fight, and the fight is epic, but the fight stops when I talk about Martha, who happens...
How do you know that name?
Who happens to have the exact same name as your mother.
Yeah.
How convenient. What would have happened if it was not?
I know. I guess that was the only way that they could make a connection between us having Martha as our mothers.
I'm an alien from another planet, and this makes no sense.
So did you feel that was the best way to link us together?
That was a cheap way.
Yeah, they could have done...
And I think you could have paid more for that.
Yeah.
So another thing is... And then I go towards Lex Luthor, where he's inside the Kryptonian ship that he made a deal with the government?
Yeah, somehow the government was behind allowing him to have access to all this stuff.
Yeah, and what we find out in the middle of the movie is that he was using Zod's body to make Doomsday.
Yep.
Or, as he calls it, the devil to fight against Superman.
And, essentially, there's a big battle against Doomsday.
Yes.
Which, I mean, he looks like he's gonna... Can't he, be...
He looks like an ogre.
He looks like
an ogre. Lord of the Rings.
He seems like he's unstoppable.
And he kind of is, kind being of is. Based off Kryptonian DNA.
So we see a bit of a preview of the Justice League with the teams trying to work together. Batman, you and I are kind of like just distracting. We're trying to distract him in some ways, but Wonder Woman is doing a lot of the work.
Yeah, she jumps in to help, as I noticed that Lois Lane is in trouble once again, where she has to be saved because she was drowning.
Yep.
Trying to grab the spear. We'll get into that soon.
Yep, spear.
So, and then the big shocker at the end.
Yeah, the death of Superman. Which, I believe it was unnecessary to end on that note. What do you think?
Yes, because at the end, when I'm in my gravestone, I lift the rocks off the coffin.
So death and return of Superman.
It's also kind of like strange because they made the last 10 minutes all about Superman's death, which is kind of like, we know I'm not gonna die because I'm Superman.
They should have just maybe ended it that way.
Yes,
and not have the Earth
extra
rising. Yeah.
Yeah, actually, I did bring that up. Like, I thought the scene ended with the cavalry fired their shots, and be like, I thought that would have been a good end, but no, we see you walking to my grave talking to Wonder Woman about making the Justice League.
Yeah.
Kind of a little bit excessive, but
I think that's why a lot of the critics didn't like it, just the way it ended as well. Well, should we bring back the spear? Because that's one of the moments in the film that could have changed everything, actually.
Yes,
they had done it a different way.
Yeah. Anyways, let's see. I wrote Justice League bait here. We already talked about that obvious bait for it. Doomsday's appearance, which I was going to say something about it, but then I realized he's in the trailer. So that was like, if you saw the trailer, this movie is pretty much ruined for
and
you.
And apparently Wonder Woman was also in the trailer.
But that was okay, because everyone was bitching about Wonder Woman. I didn't know Doomsday was in the movie at all until I saw the movie.
Which worked out better. Right?
Yes, it worked out better because I was not expecting him. So when he was in the trailer, I was like, I'm so glad I didn't see the trailer for this because that was just terrible. I don't know if it's to build up more hype with the whole, like, oh, if you don't do this, Marvel's going to like beat us to it because they revealed Spider-Man.
Yeah, it did.
Which, well, he also has not an S, but he is a spider.
Mm-hmm.
And so let's go into the inconsistencies that I mentioned that I can like think of in this movie that might have been the reason why the critics didn't like it, but I don't think so. I think mine was more reasonable.
It's Wiz and Dtyson.
Yeah, the inconsistency. So here's one. Why did the mugger just kill Wayne's parents and then run away? I thought he was a mugger. So was he trying to steal your parents' money or not? He just came in and shot them and then just left you to become Batman.
It's not just that. The critics also didn't like the fact that my father swung at the criminals, because in the comics that doesn't happen. But like I mentioned earlier, in a film it's going to be different from the comics. The fans should know that already. In the Tim Burton film, the Joker is apparently the killer of Batman's parents, and that doesn't happen in the comics at all. So,
but people were okay with it.
People were okay with it. Okay, so if you can be okay with that, I don't see why that's
he still dies anyway. So what?
People are just nitpicky these days, really nitpicky.
Yeah, so, I just don't know why the mugger, because the mugger usually came to, like, steal.
Yeah.
Like, I assumed the mugger came to steal, like, the jewels and stuff, but no, he just shoots and then runs away. What?
Yeah, that was
kind of
weird.
That was weird. Anyways.
The whole bat rise at the beginning, like, where the bats are kind of,
I think that was kind of, like, symbolism.
It was symbolism, yeah.
Oh, definitely. And then there was that one part where the bat jumped out at you when you were looking at your grave. It was like, that was an unnecessary jump scare.
Oh, yeah, true.
That was dumb. Anyways, then there's another one. How did I know Lois Lane is in the desert and later that she's at LexCorps? Like, how did I know that? Like, did Lois Lane have, like, that sonic emitter that made me know where she is? Because in that beginning scene in the desert, I just know where she is. Just that made no sense, even to me.
All right.
And the scene when at LexCorps with, does Lex Luthor actually know me, Clark Kent? Because when he came up to Bruce and Clark Kent, he's just like, oh, hey, it's Bruce Wayne and Clark Kent. Two together is so much fun. It's like, I understand if he knew Bruce Wayne because he's famous, but Clark Kent? Is he famous? Would Lex Luthor give a shit about like a reporter?
Yeah, it is rather strange. Unless he somehow knows their identities, but I don't know how.
I mean, Superman's not in the metahuman thing, so no, it wouldn't be, because in the metahuman data, they know who Flash is, they know who Wonder Woman is, they know who Cyborg is, they don't know who Aquaman is, because Aquaman's just Aquaman.
Yeah.
And he's weird when he looks at the camera, he's just like...
Yeah, and what about Aquaman? Do you think the film...
interesting take on him.
...let him out to drown? Like, they didn't give him his moment of... I mean, he could have had a moment in this film, but they didn't give it to him. Why is that?
You know, that's funny, because he should have probably, like, did something, because Doomsday was causing trouble.
Yes, they left an anchor... Not an anchor, sorry. They left a baton to be passed to Aquaman, but they dropped it in the water, and they...
Oh, the spear?
Yeah, the spear. They didn't allow him to pick it up and to save the day against Doomsday. Instead, we had the whole, you know, Superman death...
Sacrifice.
Because they want to do Death and Return of Superman. But does that make sense if they're trying to go into the Justice League? Why delve into a Superman storyline if they're going to do a Justice League film? I don't understand. So that was one of the, I think, flaws of this film. Definitely.
Oh, that's...
Aquaman should have had his moment right there. I don't know why he didn't get the spear.
Also, there was one thing that always bothered me after the movie. Why did Clark Kent's dad appear when I was in the mountains to give myself some convenient advice? Some said it was because it was all in my head and I just imagined that's what he would say, but that's kind of dumb. Couldn't I just stay at home and just figure that out myself? Why did I have to go to the mountains? Or was that a recording of him?
I guess it was just like a visual scene, but...
Kent was alive, that's okay, but he's dead from Man of Steel, so... He just appears and is like, oh, Clark, you are what you are. You should believe what you are. I don't remember his lines because it was too dumb. It was just like, I don't know why he existed there.
Yeah,
that was a very weird scene.
That was an unnecessary scene. Yeah, I do believe so.
Also, I got to say, how did you not find out my identity through the LexCorps file? And how come Alfred never told you about me during the wiretapping, because apparently there was info about Superman, me.
Well, I guess I just was full of vengeance. Well, rage.
Because, here's the thing. Because Lex Luthor knew Ma Kent was Superman's mother.
Mm-hmm.
So, he knew that. But how come Batman didn't know that? Because it's in the files somewhere.
I think they were trying to convey that Batman was going into this battle with blind rage. He did not see Superman as a human being at all. He just saw him as a threat, as an alien, so he did not even delve into his history of his family or anything of that nature.
That's weird, because you think he would have used that to his advantage, to know his enemies.
It's true, but he was just...
Go on.
I guess he just was full of revenge. He didn't even want to consider this guy as something... even remotely human, so...
But that's why you use everything against... I guess, like, if he just consider him human, it's like, oh, you must have, like, not been born on Earth.
All that Batman did is, okay, this guy's not human, what's his weakness, I'm gonna find it. That's all he seemed to do in this film.
And you should fire your butler, because, like, he was still wiretapping through LexCorp's file.
Yeah, so I guess it is plausible for someone filled with you know, revenge to just go in blindly and do something like that. But I guess as a plot, it does seem kind of strange that a guy of you know, Bruce Wayne's caliber, who loves to study his opponent or his enemy beforehand, make a plan, because that's how he beats them, wouldn't have done so in this case. He just finds the source of his main weakness, his physical weakness, and that's what he goes for.
And here's another thing. When Wonder Woman took the encryption data from you, how did she not discover about her data in the LexCorps file? I mean, she wanted the encryption to delve into LexCorps, right? So why did she not know anything about it when... She didn't know anything about it, but until you told it to her, she's kind of like, oh, there's a file on me?
Yeah, that seems kind of strange.
That's weird. And how did I, Superman, know that you were Bruce Wayne when there was no scene of me discovering that you were Bruce Wayne? Did I just look through your mask? There was no scene of that even. It was just like, I just know you were Bruce when you were about to kill me.
It must be that, yeah. Because, I mean, technically, Superman, you do have X-ray vision, so...
I don't know why they didn't just show a quick scene where I looked through it.
Well, I guess they want to leave the audience guessing, or, I mean, leave something up to the imagination, possibly.
Because Superman, I can just look through the mask and just be like, oh, Bruce Wayne.
And you could also hear everything. Remember, you could hear the Alfred conversations and everything.
I don't know why that was too important, because he didn't really do anything with that info, actually. He just knows.
He knows, yeah.
Let's see. And how did you and Alfred know it's the Russian guy who kidnapped Martha Kent? It just so happens to be the Russian guy? Well, I guess he was working for Lex Luthor, so perhaps, maybe?
Yeah, well, I guess we tracked him down with the cell phone and wired him in that way, but it's a movie. What do you think? So there's always going to be inconsistencies.
Yeah, but it's always... But I find it fun kind of talking about them. Okay, but here's one. How did Lois Lane know to get the spear to fight Doomsday when there was no way for her to know about Doomsday?
Exactly.
Because the power went out when Doomsday appeared, because he EMP'd the entire area or made like... Or no, he drained the power from the city. Yeah. So the radios wouldn't have known anything about it. Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman didn't say anything. Like, grab the spear. Like, they didn't know Doomsday was like weak to kryptonite. So Lois Lane just literally ran back into the building where we were fighting and just went to grab the spear. Like, what?
Yeah, that part made no sense. That's what.
I feel like there's a missing scene like there. Like, maybe something like we need the spear. Where'd it go? Lois, do you know where the spear is? Like, oh, it's back down there. It's like, okay, you go grab it and we'll hold off Doomsday. But no, it was just like she just runs back and she just knows.
You're right. That scene was definitely a waste. That's where Aquaman should have filled in.
Maybe he could have saved Lois Lane when she was drowning.
That could have definitely made more sense.
But then again, Atlantis probably doesn't care about humans on the ground.
Is that what it is, yeah?
Potentially. Because they're always talking about taking over the surface world.
And as you just mentioned, there were some apparently deleted scenes in this film. It was supposed to initially have an R rating, but there's apparently 30 minutes of missing footage that will be on the Blu-ray and DVD.
Well, so hopefully that will like clear up some inconsistencies. Clear up some
inconsistencies for sure.
Okay. Well, then in that case, they did rush this film out then, because It's Wiz and Dtyson. Recommendations. Would you recommend the film? Because I would.
Yeah, if you like.
And you're not nitpicky.
If you're not nitpicky, you just want to, you know, a ride.
Enjoy a superhero flick.
Yeah, if you want to be entertained, definitely, it's a good film. Don't go in with a high expectation; you'll probably be very disappointed. But if you just go in blind, you'll enjoy it.
It's kind of hard to go in blind at this point, especially if you've seen the trailer. Yeah. Avoid the trailers; they're kryptonite for this movie.
But by no means it's not a super movie. It's not a bad movie either. Somewhere in between.
It's an enjoyable movie.
It's an enjoyable movie.
Or at least it can be if you're not nitpicky. Yeah. And I certainly enjoyed it. The action scene's good.
It has its moments.
And it definitely has its moments. Plus, even the bad moments, like I said, like it was kind of fun picking out the inconsistency and trying to find out what was wrong with the film. So overall, it is kind of fun. And I would recommend watching it if you haven't already watched it.
Yes, I agree.
So with that said...
I'll be back. I'm Batman.